said Ron, Presided over care of magic. second to last exam on Thursday morning was Defense Against the Dark Arts. Professor Lupin had compiled the most unusual exam they had ever taken. A sort of obstacle course outside in the sun, where they had to wade across a deep paddling pool containing a Grindylow, cross a series of potholes full of red caps, squish their way across a patch of marsh while ignoring misleading directions from Inky Punk, then climb into an old trunk and battle with the new Boggart. "Excellent, Harry," Lupin muttered as Harry success. Harry hung around to watch Ron and Hermione. Ron did very well until he reached the Hinky Punk, which successfully confused him into sinking waist high into the quagmire. Hermione did everything perfectly until she reached the trunk with the boggart in it. After about a minute inside it, she burst out screaming. "Hermione," said Lupin, startled. "What's the matter?" "Professor McGonagall," she gasped, pointing into the trunk. She said I'd failed everything." It took a little while to calm Hermione down. When at last she had regained a grip on herself, she still slightly inclined to laugh at Hermione's boggart, but an argument was averted by the sight that met them at the top of the stairs. Cornelius Fudge, sweating slightly in his pinstriped cloak, was standing there, staring out at the grounds. He started at the sight of Harry. "Hello there, Harry," he said. "Just had an exam, I expect. Nearly finished." "Yes," said Harry. Hermione and Ron, not being on speaking terms with the Ministry of Magic, hovered awkwardly in the background. "Lovely day," said Fudge, casting an eye over the lake. "Pity, pity." He sighed. Through the castle doors behind. say something, but Hermione nudged him hard in the ribs and jerked her head toward the entrance hall. "Why'd you stop me?" said Ron angrily as they entered the great hall for lunch. "Did you see them? They've even got the axe ready. This isn't justice." whispered Professor Trelawney. Think now. Harry guessed his mind around and it landed on Buckbeak. A hippogriff, he said firmly. Indeed, whispered Professor Trelawney, scribbling keenly on the parchment perched upon her knees. My boy, you may well be seen. Staircase, wondering, had he just heard Professor Trelawney make a was not crying, nor did he throw himself upon their necks. said. His great hands were shaking as he reached for the kettle. "Where's Buckbeak Hagrid?" said Hermione hesitantly. I took him outside," said Hagrid, spilling milk all over the table as he filled up the jug. "He's tethered in me pumpkin patch. Thought he ought to see the trees and smell fresh air." Next to him trotted Cornelius. Side.